Ladies and gentlemen, good day and welcome to GE Power India Limited earnings conference call for second quarter of FY 2021-22. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Prashant Jain, Managing Director, GE Power India Limited. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Hi, very good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the shareholders call. Very pleased to have you all here. I wanted to start with wish you all a very happy festive season, happy Diwali, happy Dhanteras, and a happy festive season ahead, with many more festivals to come. We have shared the copy of the presentation. I'm joined by my team here on the call, CFO Yogesh and the other team on operations commercial, for the further question and answers. We will move in the sequence of presentation to page number three, where we talk about the update on the quarter in terms of safety, which continues to remain our priority. In the order of importance, GE Power continues to place safety, quality, delivery, and cost, which is the XQDC, as the important parameters, and the culture of continuous improvement, which is Kaizen. We start with safety as in every other meeting, where first topic I wanted to share with you is on the vaccination drive. The stage vaccination now for all office permanent employees is for eligible employees, 100%. All our employees eligible, permanent staff is now fully vaccinated in the office. The contract workforce on site, we are close to about 90% in terms of vaccination. There is still hesitancy in some of these workers, and we are working with them to get them vaccinated over the weeks and months as we speak. From that point of view, we are taking initiatives to make sure that employees remain safe to continue to be productive going forward. On safety, I have another good news to share. If you see on the right are certain awards that the teams have secured. Safety is important for ensuring safety to employees. That is important that no employee should be put into harm's way while coming to work and should be able to go back to their family safely after work. Also, it is important for productivity and for ergonomics at workplace, and therefore we put a very high emphasis on safety. The awards that we have received, one of them, the most important award on the left bottom, is the CII National EHS Competition Award won by GE Power India Limited. GE Power India Limited in this category has won the gold award on the national level on safety. GPL has been recognized as having very high standards when it comes to providing a safe working place for its employees. That is the good news I wanted to share. Among the other awards that we have received from customers, from FICCI for a project in Telangana, for another CII award for a project, CPET, and the award that you see on the right is an award that we have received for another FGD project on the site. These are certain achievements in safety. Moving to page four. I wanted to briefly update the strategic direction that we had earmarked for the company to improve the profit and margin in the mid to long term, to start focusing in the order profile, de-risk the profile. We have recognized the trend of new build moving towards services, so rapid transformation towards service. The majority of the order booking today we see has been consistently coming from services. We have also started focusing on non-EPC projects more than EPC to de-risk the portfolio. We will continue to participate in selective EPC projects. We are making bids, but we are going to be selective in the profile to ensure we choose deals which are accretive to your company, and that trend currently is on track. The third area that we chose to earmark upon was to move towards more private customers, industrial customers, as compared to the utility-based customers. Here we see a significant improvement in the ordering, especially on the service upgrades from the private customers, which is the right trend. From the strategy point, we are moving in the right direction. though the progress is slow. As you see on the top line, there is still some pressure on the order intake, which we will talk about in the coming slides. But the general strategic direction that we have earmarked for the next 3 to 5 years, we see that on track. Moving to the page six, I want to highlight the key project execution. I'm very proud to share the first picture on the left is the absorber unit of SGD on NTPC Unchahar site. And there you can see that this is where we create the drawings into reality, the project to construction, the concept, and eventually the execution at site. And that's something that is really what we are proud of as making a difference to the society by implementing these SGD instruments. And then we have a couple of good execution examples were on the service upgrade sides and the Subansiri side, which we restarted in the last quarter earlier this year. We see now good progress. A little bit on the corporate social responsibility among the other projects. One of the projects we are sharing today is where we have shared digital devices with children to bring them on speed with their digital communication, stay connected, and learn and develop themselves and their skills in the COVID times. Moving on to the next one, the next phase, we will turn upon the financials. We start with the order intake profile, and we move to the page number seven. I would hand over to Vineet, our commercial leader, to share about the key highlights of the quarter. We see certain headwinds there, while on the service, we see on track. Albeit at a slightly lower volume in the last quarter, but Vineet will add certain more details into this deck. Over to you, Vineet.
This is the operator. The line for Mr. Vineet Pant has got disconnected. We are reconnecting Mr. Pant. Request you all to please stay online. Mr. Jain, over to you, sir.
Yep, I guess Vineet is not able to join the call. I will continue with the slide. So on page six, we talk about the order profile. On page seven, we talk about the order profile. On the FGD, which is the core pillar today of our strategy, primarily the JEPIL strategy is towards FGD and services today on the steam side. And then we have small elements of hydro and gas, which continue to be stable, but they're not material to the performance of the company. On FGD, we saw slowing down of the ordering in this quarter compared to the previous year's quarter, primarily because of the government reclassification of the zones on the sites in the three categories. And the second element is the potential extension of the timeline from the Government of India from 22 to 24, December 22 to December 24, where some of the developers are waiting before they finalize their orders or make their down payments. Therefore, we see a lull in the ordering, but the pipeline is still robust and intact. We are confident that within a month or so, when the government notifies the zones for the FGD, this ordering shall restart. So that is one main reason why we see a dip in the order intake. On the services side, in the current quarter, as you may be aware, there was a huge demand on the coal-fired power plants and a temporary shortage and a peak demand after COVID restart on the coal-fired power plants. Therefore, some of the customers continued to operate their power plant rather than providing an outage or taking an outage, and therefore they deferred ordering on certain critical equipment for services. And therefore, we saw in that dip, owing to a robust demand on the power plants that were being run by our customers around that time. And therefore, we saw some postponement of decision-making by our service customers as well. In my view, that is positive. That gives confidence that the customers are still, the market is still relying heavily on these existing plants. And the need for these coal-fired power plants has been reinforced in the goal that was outlined as 2017 net carbon zero by the government of India, by Mr. Modi yesterday. That also reinforces that the fossil plants or the coal-fired power plants will continue to play a key role until 2030. So the demand is robust. Unfortunately, in the current quarter, due to softening of so moving on to the page. So moving on to the page 8, we will now move to the revenues. I will hand over to Yogesh to continue from here. Over to you, Yogesh.
Thank you, Prashant. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to this call, investor call. Coming to revenue, we have seen on the order intake slide, there are headwinds on order intake. And on the revenue side, in spite of the challenges that we were facing because of COVID, and the actions were taken by the operations team to ramp up the site, getting manpower on site, we faced another two challenges on account of heavier than normal monsoon. And most of our sites were waterlogged, making it virtually impossible to work at these sites. And the second was the outbreak of dengue. So on top of COVID, these two challenges emerged in this quarter for us to really address these challenges so as to meet the numbers or the objectives that we had set for ourselves. And here we have seen that we achieved a revenue of 7.3 billion against a revenue in the Q2 of 2021 of 8.8 billion. There is a difference of 1.5 billion. Almost about 17.5 billion, keeping in mind these headwinds that we had on account of a heavier than normal monsoon and challenges on account of availability of site manpower. And there has been, I would say, a significant portion of this revenue has come from our FGD execution, as has been in the couple of last quarters. So similar trend continues for us. And if we compare our performance in Q2 21, with the performance of Q1 of the 2021 year, we have done 35% more revenue than what we did in Q1 21. So clearly the operations are stabilizing and we are moving in the right direction on the revenue. The order backlog is now 44.7 billion at the end of the quarter two. Moving to the next slide, page number 9, which is on profit before tax. And we have had a change in the product and margin mix compared to the Q2 of FY 20 in this current year quarter. And our profit before tax has been 508 million against 505 million of last year same quarter. And here in the current year quarter, Q2 21-22, we have exceptional item of 57 million on account of restructuring costs for right-sizing the organization, keeping in the mind the market trends that we have. So if we look at the percentage of PBT versus revenue, 2021, our percentage was 5.7, whereas now for the current year, quarter two, our percentage is 6.5. And if we add back the exceptional item, exceptional expense that we incurred on restructuring, this percentage becomes 7.7. So we have been, I would say, our operations have stabilized and the profitability is moving in the right direction as revenue. This is it from my side. And I would now hand back to Prashant Jain.
Thank you, Yogesh. With this, we can open the floor to questions.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. Reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one at this time. First question is from the line of Narendra from IIFL Securities. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. For taking my question. Firstly, on the gross margin side, they are at, again, 26% lower in 2Q. Is this largely because of mix or also due to commodity headwinds? And with the Sabansari project now back in the books and executable over the next three and four years, how should we look at gross margin behaving in the next 2 years? Also, what is the status of ESP projects and how much is left in the backlog? By when do we expect it to complete?
Thank you, Narendra, for the question. And coming to the first, there are three questions that we have asked. And the first one is with regard to the... Can you repeat the first question, Narendra? My line was not very good.
Yeah. So, gross margins at 26%, they are lower than guidance. So, is this largely because of only mix or their commodity headwinds? And what? How do you expect this to go going forward?
I think we did not give any guidance on the gross margins. The gross margins of 26% are very much in line with our gross margin of 2021, the same quarter of last year as well, we were trending at 26%. And we have basically taken care of our, I would say, the impact of inflation in the projections that we have here or the numbers that we have here. And the number that we have here has been more or less in line with our mix that we have. And I don't see any divergence or change in with regard to the last year same quarter or the quarter gone by. And can we have the second question again, please?
ESP projects, like how much is left in the backlog? And
ESP projects, we are left with about 90 crores. And as we have been always sharing, that we are targeting that two out of the three projects will be completed by mid-22, and the last one will be completed by mid 23. So these three projects will be executed fully by mid 23, and we have provided relevant loss on our provisions so as to make them margin neutral in our actual achievements. And coming to the question of how the things will be on the 3-4 years down the line. We normally don't give the projections on futuristic, but on this aspect, we are very much moving in the direction of our projections or the trend that has been there in the past. And as has been always mentioned, that we have the backlog is primarily driven by steam of our FGDs, and the significant portion of almost about 55-60% comes from steam FGDs. And Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are.
Yeah, okay, thank you. And then my projections on steam services are in the range of about 12-15%, and hydro is remaining 35% almost. So we have a reasonably good backlog, and the implications on the inflation and on the commodity prices and the challenges we had factored into our last quarter. So we normally don't give any forward-looking statements, but we would be trending on similar lines on our, in the future 2-3 years down the line.
Thank you, sir. And the second question is on the net working capital. We see, again, further it has deteriorated. How do you expect this to pan out? there any delays in, like, you know, our target to reduce net working capital, or and it remains on track? Also, you target to turn cash by FY23. Does that stance continue?
Narendra, can you please repeat your question? The line has been not good at my end. I'm sorry for this. Just can you please repeat the questions? I understand one is for the working capital, is what I heard.
Yeah, yeah. Working capital has deteriorated. So further, so your targets to bring it back on track, is it still within your range? And by when do you expect to turn on net cash? You had earlier guided for FY23. Does that continue?
Yes, Narendra, thank you for the question, for repeating the question. Our working capital situation has been impacted because of increase in trade receivables to the extent of almost about 2.8 billion. And this is primarily driven by the increase in FGD retention of almost about 2.3 billion. And this is in line with the payment terms that we have on these contracts. And this has, we have been always sharing that our payment terms are skewed or are not so favorable, and major chunk is attributable or moves to retention. And so the working capital, I would say deterioration, if you use the word, or more increase in the working capital is attributable to increase in retention. And we have given an indication in the last meetings that we would be getting out of this trend, or this trend will be reversing, and we would be in a much better shape by 22-23. We are holding on to that projection, and we will be striving hard to achieve the milestones for getting these retention payments.
Thank you, sir. I'll get back into the queue.
Thank you. Reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one. The next question is from the line of Surbhi Saraogi from Smith Capital Markets. Please go ahead.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, please.
Yes. Sir, my first question is, can you give a breakup of your other income?
Normally we don't give full details, but we can share some. Basically, this comprises of Forex gain that we have had in this quarter, and some other entries that we have on the side of our, I would say, some cost provision release, etc. Yeah.
Sorry, sir, I could not catch the last one. Entries on?
I would say some reversals of some provisions or some.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, and sir, my another question is, can you give some color on your growth outlook?
I would say,
I will take that. Thanks, Yogesh. On the growth, as I mentioned earlier, primarily the focus is on the FGD and the services market. On the services, we see roughly opportunity of about $900 million. Currently, we are ranging in the 3-6% market share, depending on the product segment. And the target is to in the next 3-5 years, to get 10-15% market share in the services segment. We see that this is on track largely. Then the second area that we are currently strongly positioned is the FGD market, where we still see a good amount of opportunities. We will see that these are the two strong central pillars of the JPL business. And these two, we have recently validated with an external study done by PwC Strategy AND. And we have validated the marketing view from the marketing team with respect to what they see as an independent strategy consultant. And they have validated that there is a good amount of opportunity for next 3-5 years in the FGD and the services for the next 3-5 years. So, Vinit, if you want to add a couple of words on the growth outlook.
Yeah. So you are right, Prashant. On the FGD, we have seen there has been, of course, the last two quarters a slowdown, but there is a healthy pipeline. We still see about 140 gigawatt, which is yet to be ordered. which is total is about $10 billion. And of course, we are not, as you mentioned, we are not, we are looking at cash securities only. So we are targeting maybe around 6-7% of that market. So, but yes, there's going to be a healthy growth for FGD. And there has been a delay for the last two quarters, but I think we should start picking up from January. And services, of course, yes, it's going to be there. We have a pipeline. For core services as well as upgrades, we see a lot of deals coming up, a lot of revamping opportunities. So this is going to continue. So yes, education services definitely will be there. We are also looking at other areas, industrial boilers, industry segment. We are trying to focus also on the industry segment now, besides power. So that is also going to be a growth area going forward.
Okay, sir. That's all from my side. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Participants, to ask a question, you may press star and one. The next question is a follow-up question from the line of Narendra from IIFL Securities. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Thanks again. On the execution side, we were having a lot of issues at our site in terms of labor availability and supply chain issues also. Have all the issues not with respect to execution? And also,
Go ahead.
So if you could provide the same for this quarter between like FGD and services, et cetera.
Yeah, so first let me confirm that we see from the COVID, we are out. The manpower, we are ramping up rapidly, and we are in the range of a gap of about 10-15% on the workforce at site. So we are close to the manpower that we need on the site for the execution. So on the FGDs, we see that we have a very strong rigor in place. And I will ask Raj to add to this some flavor to this on what he is doing to ensure the execution rigor and how that execution is on track. And the second part of the question, Yogesh will take it up. So over to you, Raj.
Yeah, thanks, Prashant. So as Prashant mentioned, we got out of the COVID wave two in quarter one, and as we got into Q2, we did see a good recovery on the workforce, but challenges on front of rains which have been unprecedented, and this is not like rains which have been prolonged, but they have been short duration rains but very heavy, which has caused a lot of flooding in many of these sites. As you would imagine, most of our projects are brownfield projects, and where some of the work areas which we are doing work is not necessarily very easily accessible, and being a low-lying area within the site created significant challenges for our workforce to access and be in a position to deliver the productivity. However, we are getting out of that. Aside of that, what we have done operationally is that our approach has and in the spirit of continuous improvement, we continue to challenge ourselves in terms of better processes and systems which we are executing the site, and we are seeing a significant positive impact of that. What we call it as the Kaizen approach, where we do week long engagement, cross-functional engagement to solve challenges and progress and continue to improve our productivity and rigor of daily management. All of this is helping us to take the situation further.
Thanks, Raj. Narendra, what was the second question on the financials?
Your revenue mix for this quarter.
Revenue mix for the quarter, yes, please. Yeah, Yogesh, can you quickly address that?
Sure, I will, Prashant. And the revenue mix for the quarter that has gone by has been, you want the percentages of like specific,
yep.
Right?
Yep.
So here we have had the number is about 70% in the our basic FGDs, and about 16 to 20% in steam services, and 10% in hydro. Okay. So these are the broad percentages. I repeat, steam has been in the range of 70 plus. The steam means FGDs primarily.
Slightly
boilers. Yeah. And then we have steam services in the range of about 16 to 20%, and hydro was about 10%. And okay. The earlier question that you asked about the working capital, I would like to supplement there. There have been, as has been shared, there has been substantial pressure on working on site. So some of the milestones could not be achieved, and some retention payments could not be collected. So this has been another issue which has deteriorated or increased our working capital requirement. And we have tried to factor into how best we can address by the efforts that the operations colleagues are putting in to come back on track, but there will be definitely some delays on these retentions, and accordingly our shift in the projections on cash will happen. But still, we are maintaining that by 22-23 fiscal, we should move into the the terrain of getting out of negative cash flows.
So, were there any provisions again this quarter?
No new provisions. We had as I mentioned to Surbhi, that we had some release of provisions, a write back of provisions which were there in the other income.
So what would be the quantum of the release?
Normally we don't share. I can mention about the components. These were with regard to some on the interest sector, some on the tax side, and some on the bad debt side that we had on this provision reversals.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Participants, to ask a question, you may press star and one. Reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one. As there are no further questions, I would now like to hand the conference over to Mr. Prashant Jain for closing comments. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you all for joining the call, and wishing you all a very happy festive season. Happy Diwali. Thank you. Thank you, team, for the support. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of GE Power India Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.